Dear colleagues, I am Dr. Keyur Parikh, Senior Cardiologist at CIMS Hospital, Ahmedabad.
This is a case of a critical left main coronary artery stenosis in an elderly gentleman who presented to CIMS Hospital who otherwise had refused surgery in past. Left main coronary artery supplies the left ventricle through its two branches, left anterior descending and left circumflex artery. Lesions in left coronary artery is an indicator of high morbidity and mortality. And this is one of the few coronary lesions where medical therapy is insufficient as an optimal treatment and you need to have coronary artery bypass grafting. However, in critical patients, this can be difficult. Percutaneous coronary intervention warrants rapid reperfusion of the left main coronary artery, saving life of the patients in most cases. Isolated left main coronary artery stenosis is very rare. There is extension into the LAD and left circumflex artery. This is a 85-year-old gentleman, uncle of a doctor, coming from North Gujarat. He had exertional angina on and off since long time, but on the day of admission and the night before, he had unstable angina with severe resting pain. Previous smoker, previous history of left main coronary artery disease, which was 50% with triple vessel disease, refusing bypass surgery a few years ago, and now having severe resting angina, came with atrial fibrillation, with a blood pressure which was stable originally, and a heart rate which was on the higher side. Echocardiography at the time of admission showed mild septal hypokinesia, but otherwise normal. Patient had an urgent coronary angiography on a Sunday with a right radial approach, 5 French Tiger catheter. Left main coronary artery showed 90% lesion extending into ostial LAD with 80% lesion extending proximally, and then mid LAD did show 99% to 100% occlusion. There was a ramus occlusion, left circumflex which was non-dominant showed 80% lesion, and right coronary artery which is dominant showed 80% lesion at its origin, followed by proximal 90% lesion and mid segment showing 80 to 90% lesion. Surgery in this patient is the gold standard for last many years. However, last few years, stenting of left main coronary artery disease is primarily used in patients who are not candidates for surgery or as bailout procedure for surgery, or in limited mid-segment left main coronary disease or ostial left main where stents can be used. We are now entering the cardiac cath lab where this is a CINI angiography showing critical left main coronary artery disease and 90% LAD followed by subtotal LAD. This is a second view again showing critical left main coronary artery disease. We had a heart team with surgeon coming into the cath lab and a decision was made to do an angioplasty. Subsequently, after dilating the LAD and the proximal part of LAD as well as left main coronary artery, a long stent was introduced into the LAD, which required significant pushing due to calcific lesion. A second stent was placed into the left main coronary artery into the LAD. After the left main was dilated, adequate post-dilatation was done. Left circumflex coronary artery origin was not compromised. Final result showed resolution of the critical left main artery stenosis. And the same time, patient's chest pain resolved. Right coronary artery was cannulated with a right guide catheter, JR 3.5. Guide wire was placed across the right coronary artery. Dilatation was done in both distal, mid and proximal right coronary artery. Distal right coronary artery stent was placed, DES, drug-eluting, and proximal to mid segment also was stented adequately. Subsequent results showed widely patent right coronary artery with TIMI 3 flow. Patient stabilized immediately, chest pain disappeared, ECG normalized. Patient was hemodynamically stable on discharge after a couple of days. Discharge medication was aspirin, clopidogrel, atorvastatin large dose, metoprolol and ramipril. For left main coronary artery stenting, a heart team approach has to be done, where a heart team, which includes the cardiac surgeon, cardiologist, referring physician, has to join together in a joint decision. It is very important calculation of the STS and syntax scores are to be done and analyzed. There are indications to do angioplasty to improve survival in patients who have unstable angina or non-STEMI when left main artery is the culprit lesion, like this case, or in acute STEMI if there was a sudden occlusion of left main coronary artery. It is also important that it can be done with some degree of risk in a higher risk anatomy. However, the syntax score preferably should be less than 33. Or in patient with COPD, prior stroke, previous surgery, which is increased risk of redo bypass surgery. Another approach which we do at CIMS Hospital with our group is hybrid revascularization, where we provide LIMA to LAD many times with the minimum invasive approach called the MIX, minimum invasive coronary artery surgery, through an intercostal scar without opening the sternum. At the same time, we provide stent to left circumflex and right coronary artery. So minimally invasive LIMA, left internal mammary artery to LAD, and DES to everything else. To summarize, PCI versus bypass surgery in left main or multivessel disease, yes, you can do it, but call a surgeon, use the heart team approach, determine clinical risk calculators. Best outcomes with complete revascularization is very important. And you have to remember, diabetic patients still do long-term better with bypass surgery. Some of the trials with left main coronary artery and stenting versus surgery have shown superiority of surgery. However, in emergency and rescue cases, intervention can be done. So, take home message again. Heart team approach, chest pain patients bring to the cath lab, angiography showing left main coronary artery. You measure the syntax score, and if required, you can do the FFR, which is fractional flow reserve. Look into clinical scenario. Having seen the syntax score, if it's less than 33 and there is a emergency need to do intervention with PCI, PCI can be done according to the guidelines which I just mentioned. Otherwise, patient should go for surgery. Take-home message is drug-eluting stents reduce rate of restenosis. In current practice, the use is very widespread and there is reduction of restenosis. So PCI for left main coronary artery lesion in emergency case, in rescue cases, acute MI can be done where there is an excessively high surgical risk. Last question is, should you ever call a surgeon? Despite advances in our field, there are very few lesions we are unable to treat, but still in left main and multivessel CAD, it's always nice to discuss with the surgeon. CIMS Hospital is proud to present real-life recorded cases, and we'll continue with our series. If there are any comments, suggestions, please feel free to contact the cardiologist who has presented the cases and interact with them through either email, WhatsApp, text message. Thank you very much.